two things that are absolutely essential with the HX50 is longevity and durability. And this is the case with the main rotor gearbox, because without a gearbox, how are you going to get off the ground?
Things like this are really at the center of who the HX50 is, because without durability and longevity on parts like these, which are in the main rotor gearbox, the whole helicopter is compromised. And that is why we have to be so particular when it comes to gears and the main rotor gearbox.
People often talk about the differences between aerospace parts and automotive parts. And it's not necessarily that it's harder to make aerospace parts, it's just the fact that the consequences of an aerospace part failing can be so much more severe. And so what we have to do is we have to seek essentially as close to perfection as we possibly can in every little element of everything that we do. And one of the little processes that we've been working on recently is the copper electroplating that we need, so that we can mask off the sides of the gear and the body of the gear that need to remain tough to stand up to the duty in the gearbox, and allow us just to heat treat and harden the teeth faces of the gear, just the bits that roll together.
So electroplating is essentially where you are using electricity to plate another metal with another metal. It's a thin layering on top of the surface that creates a plating.
We have to make sure that we make a gearbox not only that can withstand the torque and withstand the power and the different temperature environments that that the aircraft's going to operate in, but we need to be sure that it's going to do that for the full 5,000 hour life, day in, day out, no matter how it's used in practice. And that means that every little detail, every little part of the process has to be absolutely perfect.
So the reason why we copper plate is basically it's a masking process, so it's to mask off areas that we don't want the carburizing, the heat treatment process to attack or penetrate. So we mask the whole gear blank with copper plating, and then we machine back the gear teeth, the flanks and the root to a plus metal condition. We then heat treat these, so we basically put them in an oven, hot quench in oil. We then strip the copper plating back, and basically the heat treatment will only penetrate, and the heat in the oven will only penetrate on the flanks and the areas that are exposed. So everywhere else that's got the copper plating, basically that's masked. And the reason why we do that is we don't want to harden around this area. Another area, we just want to harden in and around the teeth.
And why don't we want to harden the rest of the area?
That will make it brittle. So in that area, we don't want any brittleness around there. So that's the reason.
We design very carefully. We design quite conservatively. We buy the finest quality materials. We control the tolerances. We control the way that we make the parts, the processes that we use. And then we test. We test at part level, we test at sub-assembly level, and then we test at whole aircraft level to make sure these gearboxes do exactly what we think we're going to do. To build all of these parts yourself, there is a huge number of processes that you have to master and then control and then be able to execute repeatably every single time you want to make a gearbox. Now, that might seem completely innocuous and completely abstract from producing a helicopter, but it's the little things like that that you have to get right all the way along the journey to make these things work the way that they need to work, and to do that indefinitely.